Hello folks, so in this video I want to introduce this very densely populated chart to you. And what this chart is plotting, it's plotting the best efficiencies obtained in different research cells. And this plot is available on the NREL website, which is the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, and they have done this a very nice documentation of how efficiencies have evolved across different solar cells technologies as a function of time. So this chart is plotting these efficiencies at a function of time. And one of the reasons why, you know, why there's even a need to make these chart, besides to make a record of these efficiency cells, one of the other reasons why NREL does this characterization is that there could be a research group, or there could be a company, there could be a research group, say research group A, or there could be a company, say a company B. And this research group could claim, you know, that they have made a cell which has a 45% efficiency, it beats the Shockley-Coiler limit. Similarly, company B can, you know, make another claim that, you know, our cell is 2% more efficient than the best reported silicon cell. So who's going to verify these claims? So to kind of one reason for making these plots is one reason why NREL does this device characterization is to verify these claims made by either individuals or labs or companies, and verify or certify what their efficiencies in these cells are. And whenever NREL finds efficiency which is much higher or which is greater than what has been previously reported for that technology, that cell obtains, basically that cell obtains a point on this chart. So each point on this chart, it represents a record cell at that time. And sometimes, you know, there are new categories which emerge out. So for example, you look at these orange curves over here, and they represent these new emerging kind of PV technologies, such as dye synthesized or organic solar cells. And you see that, you know, these have really start to appear only after 2001. So there are new categories which might appear on these chart as well, and that represents that a new technology has been reported for a solar energy conversion. Similarly, you know, you see that sometimes people might come up with a new method of growing cells, or you know, some new manufacturing method. For example, most of the crystalline cells have been either single crystalline or multicrystalline, but there has been a new process which is making these thin films of semiconductor materials which are still crystalline. And this has been reported both for silicon, which has been reported by the startup company Solexel. Similarly, this has been reported for gallium arsenide by another company over here, which is Alta Devices. So many times, you know, on this chart, you'll see new categories emerging, and that either represents a new technology for photovoltaic conversion or a new process flow, and that warrants a separate color or a separate symbol on this chart. So, you know, let's look at what are some of the record efficiencies, and the way I want to do is start from the highest and then go to the lowest efficiencies. And so we'll look at, you know, if you look at the highest efficiencies over here. So if you look at the highest efficiency, that is around 44%, and that record is, let me use the same color as that category. So let me use the pink for this. So if I look at the maximum efficiency, it's around 44%, and that record is held by this startup company Solar Junction. And what you see over here, that you know, you can figure out a lot about these multi-junction cells just by reading or just by looking at this chart carefully. So if you look at this chart for a multi-junction solar cell, which is plotted in this in this pink kind of color over here. So you notice that these are always, if you look at this caption over here, so these are for usually involving more than one junction. So this is made up of three junction, which is what currently holds the record. There have been some cells which have been reported for four junctions, but most of these points over here, these triangle points over here, they belong to these three junction based solar cells. Another thing I noticed is that for these multi-junction solar cells, the people report efficiencies for a non-concentrator, that is at the concentration of one sun, and that is then you achieve efficiencies which are in this range, 37% range. But at the same time, when you apply a concentrator or you increase the concentration of the sun by concentrating the sunlight, then you get a much higher efficiency, and the higher you go in concentration, the higher the efficiency you get. And this is kind of again represented over here, where you can see that this particular cell had a concentration of 406x. That means it has a concentration of 406 suns, and the maximum efficient, the record efficiency holding sun current cell currently, it had a concentration of 942x or 942 sun. And you can go higher than that, but of course that would heat up your cell. So far, maximum concentration which holds this record efficiency is around 940x. So similarly, you can also see that which technology is still currently being researched and which technologies have matured out. So if you see these some of these technologies, for example, multi-junction cells, or if you see over here, if you see these organic cells over here, you see that the efficiency are still rising when I'm looking at the years which are close to the current timestamp. So you see that the efficiencies are still rising as a function of time, versus if you look at this the square blue chart over here, and this square blue chart over here, this represents the efficiency of a single crystalline cell. So we see that these efficiencies, they evolved they evolved a bit in the 1980s and 1985, and you see this record cell of sun power over here. But more recently, in the last decade, these efficiencies have not moved much. So pretty much, people have squeezed out most of the juice that they can out of these single crystalline based silicon solar cells. And at the same time, so we started from the top over here. So we started with this multi-junction solar cells. So the record holding cell currently is three junction, and it uses a highly concentrated light. And below that, if you look at efficiencies below that, they are again held by these gallium arsenide based cells, which are mostly made up of single crystalline. And more recently, there has been this work on making these thin layers of single crystalline gallium arsenide, and that is reported in these cells by Alta Devices. And then if we climb down further in efficiencies, then we find our good old friend crystalline silicon based solar cells, which are the dominant PV technologies. They hold, in fact, more than 85% of the market, and you see they have efficiencies of maxing out at around 25%. And then if we go further down this chart in efficiency, then we see these bunch of curves which are denoted by this green color, and they represent these different thin film technologies. And these thin film technologies have what has been typically called the second generation of photovoltaics. And there are many of these technologies. So there's CIS, which is copper, indium, gallium, selenium. There's a CATL, which is sold by First Solar. Then there are these amorphous silicon based technologies. And then there are these polycrystalline and nanocrystalline based silicon technologies. And you see that they have efficiencies which max out around 20%, and for CIS or CIGS based technologies. But they have a much lower cost, as much lower cost of making this PV module as compared to some of these crystalline silicon based cells. So they might still fare better on that dollar per watt matrix. But you see, they are bunched up over here, so they have efficiency of between 30 to 20%. And you see these green dots, which are filled with yellow, and these represent these cattail based technologies. So you see these are cells by First Solar, and they have reported a maximum efficiency of close to 20%. And then finally, we reach towards the bottom. So we reach this bottom of the pyramid over here. But there is plenty of room over here, and there's you see a plenty of action going on over here. See a large number of data points in the recent years, and these belong to these what is called as the emerging PV. So what's included in here is these dye synthesized based cells, or these organic solar cells. And you see they have efficiency which max out currently around 20%. So they have efficiencies of between 7 to 12%, which seems to be very low, but at the same time they can potentially be made using very low cost technologies. The pipe dream for these kind of technology is that essentially they can be made just like we print paper. So we can have a press which prints these emerging PV based technologies. And so they lie at this triangle, which is at the bottom of this efficiency curve. So this efficiency curve, is something that I'll come back to when we talk about these individual technologies. But it's a very good way to summarize or get your wrap your head around where these efficiencies of these different technologies lie, and what has been how the progress has been over the last 3 decades. Okay.